Welcome to Sport, everyone. Sean McManus will play his last game for the Fremantle Dockers in Sunday's Western Derby. Frio's favourite son has called it quits, the veteran proud of his achievements, despite not playing in a premiership.
Now that I've finished, I can say I've lasted the distance. I've lasted the distance that I wanted to set. And I'm really proud of that.
With teammates, family and friends on hand, Sean McManus called a close to a career spanning 14 years. He's the curly-haired kid who debuted in Fremantle's first season, never losing the passion and enthusiasm of day one. Often referred to as Frio's favourite son and widely regarded as the heart and soul of the club.
He embodies everything about Fremantle, a family person, traditional, unbelievably hard-working, and just a terrific bloke.
And then they write the history books of Fremantle. Sean will be chapter one.
The early days weren't easy, coming through two knee reconstructions in 2 years. He was captain through the bleak times and almost found himself on the football scrap heap at the end of 2005, but fought back to play all but four games in the following two seasons.
The writing was definitely on the wall, Fortunately, I was able to turn that around, and since then I've played three more seasons with Frio, it's been fantastic.
His final farewell to be against West Coast.
Oh, McManus.
Oh my goodness.
A perfect send-off for a man who wrote himself into footy folklore for his Derby Day courage. The only thing missing, premiership success.
When Fremantle wins their grand final and wins their premiership, I'll be knocking Pav off the stage. Hold the cup.
Katie Price, 10 News.
There are kids listening and watching. So Sean McManus will say goodbye to Dockers fans on Sunday against the arch-enemy. And being the big Channel 10 man that he is, Mac has been kind enough to join us on the emotional day. He's with Lockie Reed at Frio Oval.
Thanks very much, Tim. That was the quote of the year, Sean McManus. You've had a bit of time to think about the media conference. What are the emotions? There were no tears, Macca.
No, I held it together pretty well there, mate. But, the feeling now is still surreal. It's a decision you come to make, but I'm not sure how long it takes to come to terms with that decision. So, probably a little bit surreal at the moment.
When and why did you make it this weekend?
A couple of weeks. Well, it was probably about 3 or 4 weeks ago when I thought, what I wanted to do was get myself back in the team, play a few good games of footy and then finish on a home game. And the way it worked out is I got a game against Melbourne, and last couple of weeks I felt that I've earned my spot in the team and played well for the side. And it turns out that this weekend's going to be the home game. And I spoke with Harves only about a week and a half ago, and this is going to be it, mate.
Have you thought about life after footy, and have you thought about what you're going to do? Coaching, media, racing?
Well, I like the racing section, but I thought about coaching for sure, but I heard newsreaders like Goss get paid an absolute fortune, so maybe that's one thing we can have a look at.
Well, I'll throw you a question from Goss, because he wanted me to ask this question for you. How many of your 2,272 kicks actually hit an opponent or went over the fence?
Probably 90%.
90% of them. You did kick some goals, Macca. Stay with us, because the West Coast Eagles are the team that you'll be playing on the weekend, and they are certainly on McManus alert.
Look, it's going to be a tough one. You know, you're talking about one of the all-time great Fremantle people. Hopefully they will give him the best send-off ever, other than getting the 4 points.
Now, Darren Glass looks like he is a chance to play on the weekend. Josh Kennedy probably will miss again, Macca. But tell us about your emotions leading into this game. How do you think you'll feel Sunday afternoon about to run out on the ground?
I'll be very emotional, mate. I remember my 200th game, and I had a few tears, and I had to take a few deep breaths, and I'm sure this will be a little bit worse, to be honest. But it's going to be a great day, and it's really a celebration of my career at the Frio Footy Club, and I'm just overwhelmed by all the people who have got behind me, and I'm very privileged, mate.
And you've of course played in 21 derbies. I think you've won 7, so you're number 8, so you could win number 8 on the weekend. I wanted to ask you, have you ever thought about or been approached by the West Coast Eagles?
No, I haven't spoken to the Eagles, but I do have a soft spot for some of the East Fremantle, South Fremantle legends who have made West Coast the side that they were, particularly in the 90s.
Macca, congratulations on a magnificent career. It's going to end this Sunday, and I'm sure you're going to have a great time on Sunday afternoon.
I'll be doing my best, and it will be a great day for me. Thank you.
Thanks very much for joining us on Channel 10. Just before I go...